Welcome to the 22nd session of corporate communication. In this session, we are going to discuss about the different types of sales promotion tools. So, broadly classifying, we can say that consumers, there may be the tools directed towards consumer market or sales promotion directed to consumers, and another can be the sales promotion directed to dealers or distributor or business market. So trade promotion and consumer sales promotion for consumer market. So first we will discuss about all the sales promotion tools which are directed towards consumer market. So first one is sampling. Samples are offers of a free amount or trial of a product to consumers. So you can find a small sachet of shampoo, a small sachet of tea, a small sachet, a small packet of biscuit or something as a sample. So to induce trial, samples are given. Usually we give sample in the introductory stage of the PLC, product life cycle. The method how to distribute samples. The method might be door to door delivery, sent through mail by post. It can be samples can be picked up at a store or distributed store. It can be attached to any other product. So you have one existing product and you are going to introduce a new product. So you are providing a sample of the new product with the existing product. It can be distributed through paper, newspapers, through magazine. So sampling is the most effective, but it is most expensive way to introduce a new product. So there are few criteria where we can use sampling. Number one, the products are of relatively low unit value. So per unit, per gram cost should be low, per ml cost should be low. So per unit value should be low. We can't use it for products like gold, product like silver or something, because their per unit cost is very high. The products are divisible. That is another criteria. So we can send biscuits as sample, because we can pack 2 pieces of biscuits in a packet and we can distribute it as a sample, because these biscuits are divisible. So usually biscuits come in 100 gram pack or 75 gram packs, and there they have numbers of 10-12 biscuits are there. The third criteria is that purchase cycle should be relatively short. That when, if people are offering something as a trial, we have offered sample as a trial. So if they are satisfied with that sample, with the trial, they must come and buy. So that cycle should be short. Then second tool is coupon, or we can say couponing. Coupons are certificates entitling the bearer to a stated saving on the purchase of a specific product. Coupon can be mailed, emailed, enclosed in or another product. It can be inserted in the magazine, newspaper, advertisement. It can be delivered through SMS. It can be delivered through WhatsApp even. Coupons can be effective in stimulating sale of a mature brand and inducing early trial of a new product. So you buy one product and you get a coupon. So coupons can be of different varieties. So one is bounce back coupon. These kind of coupons are applied only on return visit. So you have bought one product and you have got a coupon with that product, but you can redeem the value or redeem the benefit of that coupon only when you buy it again or you come to the store again. So coupons can be given for a store or for a specific product also. So in Big Bazaar, they used to offer coupons. You buy garments of 1,000, you will get a coupon of 250, which you can redeem in your next purchase. So that is one example of bounce back coupons. Cross-ref couponer said that when you are buying a product of brand X, but your coupon will be redeemed on another brand Y. So that is cross-ref coupon. Instant coupon means the moment you have bought, with that you have got a coupon and that coupon can be redeemed instantly at the time of billing. Then third one is the cash refund offers or rebates. These are like coupons, except that the price reduction occur after the purchase rather than at the retail shop. So cash refund, so you have purchased something, you have to submit the proof of purchase to the marketer, to the manufacturer, and in return they send some kind of refunds. Sometimes that refund can be through check, through money can be you can get refund in e-wallet. Electronic mode. So then the price back. These are offers to consumers of saving of the regular price of the product flagged on the label or package. So you can find large size packets of biscuits. Normally biscuit is coming in 100 gram, 200 gram, but you can find a price pack in which 6 packets of 100 gram biscuits are packed in a separate pack and offered with some reduced price. So it can be a reduced price pack or a banded pack in which two related products are banded together, like toothbrush and toothpaste, detergent powder with some soap and detergent powder or something. So price pack and price pack is also known as value pack. So these are the example of price pack and banded pack. So you can see 3 bottles of Harpic and it is stated that buy 2 get 1 free. This is the same product. In Vaseline, the products are different of a same company, but products are different. This is a kind of banded pack. Horlicks, This is also a value pack, price pack. Then premiums or gift. These are merchandise or service offered at a relatively low cost or free as an incentive to purchase a particular product. So you are getting some kind of gifts, some kind of premiums with the product which you are buying. Sometimes it can be the packet itself as a gift. So it is a reusable container. So these are incentives, additional incentives to buy a product. Also, there is a self-liquidating premium. Let's understand through an exam, through a graph. Self-liquidating premiums. So these are the example of premiums like Kellogg's, this jar, Kinder Joy, the gift, the toys, the small toys. With Maggie, you are getting a small box container. With Ariel, this is a kind of a small bucket, a small box. So these are the things which is making your product more attractive. So this is an example of self-liquidating premium. So you have the customer has purchased product A, and for that he has paid, say for example, 1,000. Customer has bought a product A at price 1,000. Now the seller is offering another product. If the customer has purchased product A, for them only, the seller is offering another product B at 50% off or 60% off. So these are self-liquidating premium, means we are offering some other item at the lower cost, and this additional item is associated with some kind of condition, like you have to buy this item or this value of item, then only you can be entitled to buy these products at this rate. Then the prices, these are the offers of the chance to win cash, trip, merchandise as a result of purchasing something. So so it is also associated with the product, and the product has sold. Customers who have bought that product, they can be entitled for some prizes. So usually these prizes are drawn through lottery system. Like for example, Pepsi offered a chance to win cash by matching numbers under the bottle cap with number announced on television. So the number which is announced on television, if that number has matched in your Pepsi cap, so you can win the prize. Sometimes the prize can be spending time with some kind of celebrity, like dinner with Shah Rukh Khan. Then patronage award. So these are values in cash or in other forms that are proportional to one's patronage or loyalty to a certain company or brand or a store. So these are loyalty awards. So if you are regular visitor to Big Bazaar, regular visitor to Vishal, or regular visitor to any store, they are going to give some kind of points, loyalty points associated with your billing. So these are patronage awards. Sometimes frequent flyer plans by airlines, or some kind of additional discount at hotels for regular visitors. These are also examples of patronage award, or you can say loyalty awards. Then free trials, test rides. These are free trials. These are something we can say derivative of sampling. So the products where sampling is not possible, we can offer free trials. Like for dress materials, we give free trials. Test rides are offered on automobile products. Free demonstration for products like Eureka Forbes vacuum cleaner. So through these tools, consumers' initial hesitation reduces and the confidence over the product increases, and which helps them to take decision about the product or about that brand. Then product warranties. So this can also be used as a promotional tool. So if a company is providing an extended warranty of one year normal warranty and 1 year extended warranty. So with this extension in warranty, consumers' confidence about the product may increase. Consumers may feel that the quality of the product is definitely better. That is why company has extended its warranty. So this warranty has some kind of association with the perceived quality of the product. Then tie-up promotions means there is a tie-up with two brands. Usually it's two brands, two companies, or two brands of the same company. POP displays, these are another tools, sales promotion tools. So POP displays, there may be a lot of variations of POP displays, like shelf talkers. So like you can find the image of self talkers, means these things you can find easily in any organized retail store. So there people less people will be required, and these shelf talkers will give information about price, about any kind of offer. Even they can give signs of where to go. These are the example of danglers. You can see the decorated shelf of Tide, dedicated shelf of Dettol. So all these are different variation of different varieties through which your store can be decorated and can act as a tool to attract consumers. Then product demonstrations are also there. So products are being shown in action. So consumers can visit the store to see the product in action. Sometimes if it is not possible, products are taken to the location of the customers. Sometimes customers are invited where the product is actually used are in use. Then this is deferred payment plan. So this is a creative payment plan, or you can say EMI plan. So pay use today and pay later. So through these deferred payment plan, products are available at, you must have got the communication that products are available at 0% EMI, 0% interest. Products are available at EMI, no down payment. So all these are example of deferred payment plan. So you can, these plans are going to minimize the barrier, initial barrier of purchase. Then contests are there. So there may be contests like quiz contest, slogan writing, logo designing, or something. Even there are few questions will be asked regarding the brand, regarding the product, and on the basis of lucky draw, you can win the, you can be a winner of the contest. Now we are coming to trade promotion tools. All these, the which we have discussed, are part of ATL, above the line tools, and now we are going to discuss about BTL, below the line tool. This ATL and BTL, this is about the line of visibility. When your promotional tools are visible to all, it is ATL, above the line of visibility. And if it is visible to channel partners only, consumers are not aware about the incentives, then it will be known as below the line tools. They are directed towards channel partners. So trade promotions can persuade the retailers or wholesalers to carry and promote the brand. Trade promotion can induce the retailers to promote the brand through featuring, display, and price reduction. Trade promotion can stimulate retailers and their sales clerks to push the product. So examples can be contest incentives. So special incentives are provided to distributor, wholesalers, or other channel partners to stock more and more. Sometimes contest can also happen, like the best highest seller in a specific geography will go to will get such kind of gift, or go to a trip or something. So these are contests. Contest means some kind of competition is there. Then push money, also it is known as the spiff. So push money are given to the sales force who are pushing the product to the customers. Then price off or buying allowance or trade discount. So manufacturer may offer a price off, which is a straight discount on the basis of list price on the stocks purchased during a stated period of time. So so the scheme may goes like, if you buy 100 refrigerators during this period, the company will offer 10 refrigerators free. So it can be free goods, some extra cases or something. Then promotional allowances. So Manufacturers often give retailers allowances or discounts for performing certain promotional or merchandising activities in support to their brand. The manufacturer generally has guidelines or a contract specifying the activity to be performed to qualify for a promotional allowance. The allowance is usually a fixed amount per case or a percentage deduction from the list price for merchandise ordered during the promotional period. Slotting allowances or slotting fees. These are usually given to handle a new product. So retailers, today the retailers have become more powerful. Bargaining power have enhanced. So retailers are demanding some kind of extra allowance to keep the brand in their store or for stocking or for showcasing. So displays and POP materials. So point of purchase, POP means point of purchase, POS is point of sale. So there are a lot of things which can be used for displaying or decoration purpose. They can convey some kind of communication also. Sales training program. So another form of manufacturer-sponsored promotional assistance is sales training program for reseller personnel. So through these training programs, the executive or salesperson of a store or channel partner are trained about a new product, its features, its benefits and advantages, and how it should be pitched to customers. So in B2B market, sales promotion tools can be a bit different. Like there we can use trade shows or exhibitions, trade fairs. We can organize seminars, conferences. We can use corporate gifts, festival, on any festivals like Deepavali, New Year's. We can also organize entertainment programs. Also, networking can be used. Thank you.